The officials from the Allied Professional Council of Uganda, together with Iganga District Health officials and police, started the operation at a hospital near Bulubandi Health Center 2 at Bulubandi Village in Nachigo Sub-County. At the facility, a nurse identified as Christine Babirie denied being a health worker and pretended to be a tenant, and upon searching her room, papers and drugs were discovered.
All these rooms are admission rooms.
Officials also discovered that the testing kits and machines at the facility were not functional. Christine Babirie was grilled for putting people's lives at risk. The officials later closed the facility with the help of Daniel William, the LC1 chairperson, Iganga District.
But with off. Oh my God.
During the operation, Juliet Nakasango, who was found operating a clinic using a license in different names, was also arrested. The officials got resistance at People's Emergency Clinic located in Iganga Main Hospital, where Dr. Musa Kaziwe resisted moving out of the clinic due to lack of operational license. He was later ordered to close the facility. The officials proceeded to Milan Medical Center, Choice Medical Clinic at Busei Village, and Trust Medical Clinic at Nambirka Village, where health workers were arrested due to lack of professional documents and licenses. At Ali Kasanda's clinic in Chigulu Village, officials were shocked to find witchcraft substances in the facility. Upon questioning, Cassandra revealed that someone forged papers for him to earn a living.
They have used it for food.
Yeah? Are you still practicing? Human, are you practicing witchcraft? So now what do you want to do?
The operation ended at St. Anthony Life Clinic in Igamba Zone, Iganga Municipality, where Robert Mukone was arrested for impersonating a doctor.
So who gives you the permission to run a facility when you are not qualified?
Can you choose to start here, Tom?
What am I doing? I thought I was dealing with titus, by the way. Gentlemen, who gives you the permission to run a facility here when you are not qualified? Who gives you that authority?
Henry Bakumbaine, the Busoga Regional Allied Professional Supervisor, vowed to continue with such operations in order to save people's lives.
We are actually targeting facilities that are having no licenses and the facilities that are being operated by persons who never went to school. The ones we commonly call quacks. These people, they call quacks, tend to mismanage patients. And if they do mismanage patients, they make their illnesses to become complicated. Of late, we are having a problem of resistance to drugs. It's coming as a result of these people who are never trained. And this operation is going to continue to all the other districts in Busoga.
The Iganga District Health Officer, Dr. Patrick Kitimbo, vowed not to allow the closed facilities to reopen without meeting the required standards.
So my appeal to everybody who is running a health facility in the district is to ensure that they are registered with the responsible bodies and have got qualified staff in order to provide quality health services. For those we have closed, when they bring the necessary requirements, qualified health staff, registration from the professional bodies, we shall open them, provide they meet the standards.
The culprits were taken to Iganga Police Station. Report by Ivan Wachibi for the news.